What's the relationship here? Are they the same? Enantiomers? Quickly finding R and S, we see the alcohol is R and S, or opposites, enantiomers. The bromine is R and R, same thing. And what about this molecule? The blue chlorines are R and S, enantiomers. The purple chlorines are S and R, also enantiomers? Actually, no, no, and definitely no. In previous videos at layoversci.com/chirality, linked below, we looked at how to find chiral centers and designate R and S no matter how it's presented. In this layoversci video, we'll look at what happens when the molecule has more than one chiral center. If a molecule has more than one chiral center, we use 2 to the n to find the maximum number of potential stereoisomers, where in this molecule, OCH3 and chlorine both sit on a chiral carbon, and if n is equal to the number of chiral centers, we have a maximum of 4 potential stereoisomers. Let's find them all using a simple copy and flip method. I start with the skeletons, and then I copy the substituent and flip the chirality. On the right, the starting molecule has 2 wedges, so we put both substituents on dashes. For this next one, I'll keep the first substituent the same and flip the other, and then find its mirror by flipping both. Wedge becomes dash, and dash becomes wedge. Now that we have the structures, let's find the relationship between them. The standard method of finding R and S for every single chiral center absolutely works, but takes so much time. Instead, we'll solve for one set and then find the rest using the swap method that I teach in the videos linked below. If one swap gives me the enantiomer, having OCH3 on a wedge for R means OCH3 on dashes for S. And wedge, of course, is still R. Same thing for chlorine. Having chlorine on a wedge gives me R, which means chlorines on dashes give me S. Not confident with the trick? Pause the video, prove the R's and S's. As for the relationships, if R to S is a mirror image or enantiomer, when the entire molecule is mirrored, the molecules are enantiomers to each other. What if it's only partially mirrored, where I have RR on one chiral center and RS on the other? In this case, the molecule is of 2 minds, or diastereomines, giving us a diastereomer. Even without the R and S designation, the quickest way to identify a diastereomer is to see that one substituent on the molecule is exactly the same and the other is opposite. This gives me another set of diastereomers. And let's not forget the corners. We have one that is different and one that is the same for another set of diastereomers. And the same thing here. This became so messy, so let's summarize. If you have 2 chiral centers, for a maximum of 4 potential stereoisomers, every molecule will tend to have 1 enantiomer and 2 diastereomers. Pause this video if you need a minute for it to sink in, and let's continue. Now let's try it with 2,3-dibromobutane. But before we dig in, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and hit that bell icon so you don't miss out on any new videos, and let's count. I see 2 chiral centers. Does that mean I have 4 stereoisomers? And will each molecule have 1 enantiomer and 2 diastereomers? We start with 4 skeletons and draw 1 chiral molecule. I'm choosing to put both bromines forward. And then we'll copy and flip both bromines on dashes, keep one and flip the other, and of course it's enantiomer. Next, we could find R and S for each one, but what if we don't? What if instead we just look at it the way we did before? These 2 molecules are mirrors at every chiral center, making them enantiomers. These 2 appear to be mirrors as well. Are they enantiomers? Actually, no. These 2 are not enantiomers. It's the exact same molecule. The green bromine is R. The purple is also R. That makes their enantiomers S and S. And on the bottom, we have the green R, green S, purple S, purple R. Once again, if we have R and S, then S and R, how are they not enantiomers? The difference between this and our last example is that both chiral centers have the same exact substituents. We have bromine, a methyl group, and don't forget that invisible hydrogen.
Here I have a molecule with two chiral centers. You'll notice that they each have the same four unique substituents: white, red, green, and the other side. White, red, green, and the other side. If I rotate it, notice that internal plane of symmetry, where this half is reflected in this half right down the middle. It's exactly the same. If I take this molecule and build its mirror image, notice the plane of symmetry going down the middle. These are not enantiomers because look at what happens when I rotate it. They are perfectly lined up. They are the same exact thing.
Let's draw it out with this molecule. And we won't look at the invisible hydrogen. We'll do a 180 degree rotation around the central bond between the two chiral centers. We'll tilt the results slightly and redraw the molecule as follows. The left half doesn't change, with bromine coming out of the page. This is where I had a rotation. And that gives me, for the right side of the molecule, where I have the purple bromine, a methyl group that is down in the plane of the page, because 180 degrees from up in the plane of the page gives me down in the plane of the page. Bromine is down and into the page. Rotated 180, we get up and out of the page. Down becomes up, dash becomes wedge. And look at that. I have an internal plane of symmetry in the molecule. I have an enantiomer within the molecule itself where one half reflects on the other. This is called a meso compound. And while we do have two chiral carbons, the molecule is optically inactive because the symmetry cancels each other out. If I do the same thing for this molecule, where I keep the left the same, and for the right, methyl goes down in the plane of the page, bromine wedge down is now dash up, and once again, internal symmetry. If we bring them side by side, they appear to be mirror images of each other, but if I flip this molecule as I did with a model kit, they are perfectly superimposable on each other, and that makes them the same exact thing. Going back to our original example, no, these are not enantiomers, it's exactly the same thing. And if they're exactly the same, we have a total of three rather than four stereoisomers. So what about this equation? 2 to the n equals 4 max, but the meso compound costs us one. How do you recognize the meso compound? 1, the chiral molecule has the same exact substituents on each chiral center, and 2, they have the opposite chirality. One is R, the other is S, or one is S and the other is R. But this is the long way. The faster way, which isn't always possible, is to look for that internal mirror. Take these chair conformations, for example. The molecule has two OH groups, but we can't necessarily see an internal plane of symmetry. What I can tell is that the two molecules are mirror images of each other, and so they are potential enantiomers. When in doubt, flatten it out. If you didn't immediately recognize that the OHs going up means that they're internally symmetrical, just flatten it out. We'll make these carbons 1 and 2 and put both OHs on a wedge since they're coming up and out of the chair. And look at that. Internal plane of symmetry, meso compound. Or you can go back to option 2 and find R and S on your chair conformation or on your flattened structure. R and S with identical substituents once again confirms that this is a meso compound. For even more on chirality, including videos, practice quiz, and cheat sheet, visit layofforsci.com/chirality, link below. Again, that's layofforsci.com/chirality.